We're on West Okoboji in northwest Iowa, and I want to talk to you about walleye fishing on here. We're going to start right here on the west side. Real good area right off of Pocahontas Point. That weed line that goes out across there over to Eagle. A lot of people fish that for walleyes. Just right at the very edge, it's a real quick drop off there. And so the weed line is pretty well defined until you get down to the north end, and then it scatters a little bit more. But back in Emerson Bay, on the inside weed line, the weeds go clear across both points, and it's probably several blocks wide. And once you get on the inside, then you can get to the 30-foot water, and there's walleyes out there in that. You'll find bait fish piled up. And when you find those bait balls, fish underneath them, because the walleyes are going to be down below, running up into them and feeding on them. The shore fishing can be very good over by the Emerson Bay campground and park at night. Off of Eagle Point can be very good. As we come on around to Gull Point, there's a lot of people fish Gull Point, a good place to wade out. In the evening, they'll even come right up to shore there. And then going on around from there is Miller Bay. Be sure to slip bobber the reefs that are out in the bay. They kind of come off of the south point and curve back off to the northwest. And then also there's kind of a dog bone point that comes out off of the west, northwest side that is very good for slip bobbering as well. And very effective in that bay. And then over on the north shore of Miller Bay, a couple of good areas over there. Just look for the structure on your topo map, and you can Lindy rig them, back troll it, or slip bobber it. As you go on north from there, you get to the Village West area, and that can be very good in through there, along around opener. Go ahead and fish the Rapalas and Twisters in toward shore in the evening. You can catch a lot of walleyes there at times. This lake tends to be a little bit spotty, but you work enough area, you'll find them. Then you get on down toward the harbor and lighthouse area, and Triboji. In between there is a nice rock reef that comes out. It won't be holding any weeds early in the year. You can troll over the top of it with small crankbaits. And I know that the contest's been won a couple of years up here on the Easter Seals contest. So if you are in the area on opening up here, be sure to support the Easter Seals. And you'll have a chance for a $10,000 tagged fish as well. And so anyway, the north end up there, fairly good walleyes, especially off to the east side. As you come across on the east, come out a ways and there's a gravel bar. That's very good. Come up to Pike's Point, and that's very good. Another gravel bar this side of that. And then it's kind of hit and miss as you get up along that east shore. Nothing real special that I'm aware of. And you get on up to Fort Dodge Point and fish that area across the mouth of the bay there. We're just coming up to Fort Dodge here now. I'll pull this back a little bit so you can see better. And that's Smith Bay back in there. And there's some walleyes back in Smith as well, and over toward the bridge where you go between the lakes, there's some current there, and that can be very good as well. Coming along this side of the east and south side of Smith Bay, right there off of Pillsbury, is the Abby Gardner cabin is right on that point there. And a lot of guys in the spring slow troll walleyes right there. Just a real good area all the way down this shore, down along Sunset down here, clear to the water plant. So anyway, this, all in all, this is just a generally good good walleye lake. A little tough to fish at times, like I say, but you can do well here if you work it hard and don't give up on it. But remember, catch and release on the big ones. Wear your flotation devices. And remember, catch and release. There is a slot limit here, so check your regulations for the slot, and you can have a great time fishing West Okoboji. So good luck.